सो टुडे वी विल डिस्कस द टॉपिक कूलम्स लॉ इन वेक्टर फॉर्म विच इज़ द वेरी फर्स्ट आर्टिकल ऑफ चैप्टर वन. डिस्कसिंग दिस टॉपिक फर्स्ट आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस व्हाट इज कूलम्स लॉ. सो कूलम्स लॉ, एज यू ऑल नो, देयर आर टू टाइप ऑफ चार्जेस, पॉजिटिव चार्ज एंड नेगेटिव चार्ज. As you all know, if both the charges are of same polarity, means positive positive or negative negative, then they will repel each other. And if both the charges are of opposite sign, means positive negative and negative positive, then they will attract each other. So, as you all know, if both the charges place at some distance r, then they will exert some type of force, and that particular force is known as electrostatic force. So electrostatic force is basically force between these two charges, that is known as electrostatic force. Now how we can calculate the electrostatic force? So Coulomb's, which is scientist name who has given this law, that the magnitude of force is directly proportional to, for example, these are two charges Q1 and Q2, then the magnitude of the force is depend on the Q1, Q2 and inversely proportional to the distance between them. So F, we can combine these two equations, F directly Q1 Q2 over R square. So as you all know that the, if distance will increase, then force between them will be decreased. You can imagine this by a magnet example, that if we place magnet with a large distance, then the magnetic field be very low. So in same case, if two charges are placed at some distance, then the force between them will be very less, and if both are placed with low distance, then they have very large force. So magnitude of force will be F is equal to, so as you all know, when we remove this directly proportional sign, here a constant will come. So F is equal to K Q1 Q2 by R square is known as Coulomb's law. So what is this K here? So K will tell you about the medium. It will basically give you about the information of medium, that two charges are placed in a vacuum or some other medium, like in water or in some other medium. So K here is known as electrostatic force constant, which will give you information about the medium. So value of K is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught, where epsilon naught is permittivity. So what is epsilon naught? Basically it tells us about that we are dealing in electronics now. So value of K, as you all know, 4 is constant, pi is constant, and value of epsilon naught is, here naught is representing that we are talking about the vacuum. So value of this permittivity in vacuum will be 8.85 10 raised to power minus 12 coulomb square newton inverse meter minus 2. So this is the value of epsilon naught. When I will put this value here, then K will be 1 by 4 into 3.14 into 8.85 10 raised to power minus 12, then the value of K will be 9 into 10 raised to power 9 newton meter square coulomb minus 2. So this is the value of K. So I am just telling you about what is special in K, epsilon naught. As I told you that epsilon naught will give you about the value, information about the medium. So as you here, you can see that the value of epsilon naught, I'm talking about vacuum. So if both charges are placed in vacuum, then imagine the value of force will be maximum or minimum in case of vacuum. So you can easily imagine that the value of force will be maximum in case of vacuum. So as force will be maximum in case of vacuum, then the value of epsilon naught will be minimum. So this is the minimum value of epsilon naught which will be possible only in vacuum. 8.85 × 10⁻¹². As I will introduce both charges in some medium, then the value of epsilon naught will be increases and force will be decreases. So you can easily, by numerically, you can see that F and epsilon naught both are inversely proportional to each other. As epsilon naught increases, basically medium value will be increases, so force will be decreases. So we can conclude that the value of force will be maximum in case of vacuum only. So now we will discuss Coulomb's law in vector form. So this is the basic knowledge about the Coulomb's law. So for this article, first I will consider two charges, Q1, Q2, placed at some distance with respect to origin. So this is your position vector, R1 vector. So this is your R2 vector and this is your displacement vector. Basically, displacement vector is the distance between these two charges, and the position vector is the distance from origin. So now, as you all know that for vector we must have magnitude and direction. So magnitude 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q1 q2 by r square. So this is your magnitude. If we want that f should be vector, so you have to mention direction so that it can become vector. So for now, this is your Coulomb's law in vector form. But as you all know that these two charges can repel each other or attract each other. So we have to consider two cases. So first I will consider repulsion case. Means I am considering that these two charges are of same polarity, either positive or negative. In this direction because of repulsion, and this charge will move in this direction because of repulsion. So in vector you have done this property that R12 vector will be equal to R2 vector minus R1 vector, means final minus initial. So this Q2, this will cover this distance, means it will be R2 minus R1. I can write this as R12 cap. So this charge will move in this direction R12 cap. Similarly, this will move in this direction R2 cap, because I can write this as R1 minus R2. So this is its final position minus initial position. Final will be in this direction and initial because of this charge. So force will be F is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 Q2. Now force on this first charge because of this charge. First we will calculate force on this charge because of this charge. It will become 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 Q2. Now I have to mention here distance. So you can see that this charge will move in this position. So I have taken this as R21 square into R21 cap. So just I am here mentioning positions vector, means notations or numbering of position vector. So this will become your F12 vector. Similarly, you can write F21 vector will become 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 Q2 over. It will moving here. So I can write R12 square dot R12 cap. So now I have to prove that this follows Newton's third law. So as you can see that F21 vector is equal to F1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 Q2 by. So I am here using properties of vector that you have studied in plus 1 class, that R12 square will be equal to R21 square and R12 cap is equal to minus of R12 cap. So I am using these properties here. R21 square dot R12 will become equal to R minus of R21 cap. So F21 will 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 Q2 over R21 square minus I am taking here R21 cap. So 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 Q2 R21 square R21 cap, it will equal to F21 is equal to minus F12. So hence proved that Coulomb's law follows Newton's third law. As you all know, what is Newton's third law? To every action there is equal and opposite reactions, means FA is equal to minus of FB, you have studied. So similar manner, the F21 is equal to minus F12 vector follows Newton's third law. Now we will consider the attraction case. So again I have two charges Q1 and Q2, R1, R2, and this is your position vector R. Okay. So in case of attraction, as you all know that these charges will be of opposite sign, either positive negative or negative positive. Now because of this is your first charge and this is your second charge, force on this first charge because of second charge. Now this will move in this direction because of attraction, and this here force will be F21 means force on 2 due to 1. This charge will move in this direction. So value of force will be F is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 Q2 by R square R cap. Now I have to just mention the notations. So you can see that force on 1 due to 2. So this charge will move in this direction. So R, its final position is R21 and initial is 1. So I can write that its final position is 2 and initial is 1. So I can write it as R12 cap, and this charge similar manner I can write R21 cap because its final position is on one side R1, final is R1 minus initial is R2 cap. So you can write force on 1 due to 2. Force on 1 due to 2, this charge is moving in this direction and the position vector of this is R12 cap. So in you can simply learn that in case of attraction, both the notations force and distance is same, and in repulsion case both are of opposite order. So it is already proven here. So F21 will be 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 Q2 R21 square R21 cap, because this charge is moving in this direction because of this charge and this position is R21 cap. So now again I am proving that Coulomb's law follow Newton's third law in case of attraction. F21 cap is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 Q2. I can write R21 square as R12 square because both are equal. I am using here properties of vector again. So R21 I am writing minus of R12 cap. Minus I am taking here, it will become 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 Q2 R12 square R12 cap. So I can write this as F12 vector. So again, hence proved that Newton's Coulomb's law follows Newton's third law. One more point, that if value of Q1 Q2 is greater than 0, then the nature of charge will be. So if the value of Q is both the charges is positive or negative. So as you can see, if the both charges are of positive sign or negative sign, both charges are of positive or negative sign, positive result will be positive. In case of negative, again result will be positive. So overall force will be greater than 0, means positive. So if Q1 Q2 is of same sign, then result will be Q1 Q2 is greater than 0. So this case will be repulsion. सो इफ बोथ द चार्जेस आर ऑफ ऑपोजिट मीन्स साइन, पॉजिटिव नेगेटिव, नेगेटिव पॉजिटिव, सो ओवरऑल रिजल्ट विल बी लेस देन जीरो, मीन्स वैल्यू ऑफ क्यू वन क्यू टू विल बी लेस देन जीरो एंड द नेचर ऑफ चार्ज विल बी ऑफ और दे विल फील अट्रैक्शन. सो दिस इज ऑल अबाउट कूलम्स लॉ.